Hello, I'm Chris from Backlight. In this video, I'll show you how to set up the Iconik Storage Gateway on macOS. The Iconik Storage Gateway, or ISG as I'll call it from now on, is what allows Iconik to manage your local or on-premise media files via Iconik's cloud interface. The ISG does this by syncing your folder structures from your SAN, NAS, or personal computer to the cloud, using original file uploads or local transcoding to only upload proxies and keyframes. In this specific example, we'll look at how to set up an ISG so Iconik can handle the files on an SSD connected to my MacBook. Please note that to manage ISGs, you must be logged in as a power user with admin access. To kick things off, head to Iconik's knowledge base and search for installing ISG on macOS. Or you can just head to this URL. Here, you'll find all the details you need to set up your ISG. As I mentioned earlier, you can see at the top here that local transcoding is required to view your local content in the Iconik web browser. If you upload all of your original assets to the cloud, you can choose to transcode there instead. For this example, we'll use local transcoding. To use local transcoding, you will need to download FFmpeg to transcode audio and video, ImageMagick for images, and GhostScript for PostScript language and PDF files. You can download each software separately, but we recommend installing via the Homebrew Package Manager for macOS. So let's do that now. First, download Homebrew by heading to brew.sh. Copy the terminal command from Homebrew. Next, open up your Mac's terminal. Paste in Homebrew's terminal command and hit enter. You may be prompted to enter your user password, so type that in at this stage if so. Hit enter again to begin the Homebrew installation and let it install. Once the process finishes, Homebrew will show your computer name, followed by an at symbol and your username, followed by a dash and a percentage symbol. We need to paste a command following this to add Homebrew to our path. Copy the lines here from your terminal as shown. And paste them back into the terminal after the percentage symbol. Now hit enter. Now, we need to add the install code for the various packages required for local transcode. You can get this back on the ISG on macOS help page. Here are the packages we need. You can see we're also downloading things like Bento4's MP4 MUX and XSIF tool, the uses of which you can learn about on the help page. Copy this line. Head back to the terminal and paste it after the percentage symbol. Now hit enter. Now we can let those installs run. Once they're done, you're set up for local transcoding. Next, you need to install the ISG package itself. Go to the help docs and click the link to download the ISG package. Once the package has downloaded, run it. Work through the installer to install the ISG onto your Mac. Once the installation is successful, the ISG setup wizard will appear. If the wizard does not appear, you can open it from the new ISG icon that will now sit in your desktop menu bar. Click Next on the ISG Setup Wizard. This will automatically open a window featuring your logged in Iconik account so you can authenticate and allow the ISG to connect. Remember, for this to work, you must be logged in or log in at this stage as an admin power user. Click Allow and the ISG wizard will reappear. Now you need to run through the wizard to set up your new ISG. The option to connect to an existing ISG is also available if that's what you want to do at this stage. Let's click Next. To set up your ISG, the first thing you need to do is name it. This will be the name that will show in the Admin Storages section and that your collection tree in Iconik, so make sure it's recognizable. I'll call this one New MacBook ISG Chris. Next, you need to set the local folder you want the ISG to scan. It should be the highest point in the path. In this example, I'm going to set the local folder to /volumes/SSD so the ISG can scan an external storage device connected to this MacBook. Click Next and you'll see that this ISG is set up and ready to go, so we can hit Finish. We've now completed the ISG installation process. The ISG is already starting to scan this Mac, so let's stop that so we can finish configuring the ISG by telling it specifically how we want it to work. Stop the scan using the ISG icon in the top navbar. Now, click Configure to configure the ISG in Iconik. Here, you can see we've been taken directly to the storage settings for our new ISG. You can find these settings anytime by going to your admin interface, selecting storages via the left-hand menu, and selecting your ISG. Here, we're looking at the general settings for our new MacBook ISG. First off, let's double check that the mount point is correct. In this example, we can see that the mount point is what we want it to be, so we're good to go. Next, let's head over to the scan settings. Here's the scan settings UI. If there are specific folders you want to scan for assets, you can use the scan directories field to enter the file path to those folders. In this example, we only want to scan one folder, so let's find the content we want the ISG to scan. Here, on an SSD connected to my Mac, I have a folder of content containing some motion graphics. I want the ISG to scan this folder, so I'll right-click on the folder, and then option click to copy the folder as a path name. Now I'll head back to the scan settings for my ISG, and I'll paste the path name into the scan directories field. I'll delete the volumes SSD part, as I do not need to include the mount point as part of the path. Now, I can hit the plus icon to lock in the directory for scanning. And that's added. If you want to scan everything under the mount point, you could leave this field blank. Conversely, if you wanted to add additional directories for scanning, you can do so via the scan directory fields that appear below. Once you're done, you can hit the update button at the bottom of the page to save your settings. The scan settings have been successfully updated. You can also update other options from this UI, such as adding folder name tags to auto tag assets with the folder path. You can tell the ISG how often to scan your folders, tweak the growing files threshold, and tweak other options for files, such as ignoring file patterns or file types that you don't want to scan. You can also do things like set controls around who has permission to view and use the content your ISG scans. Set the ISG to automatically upload original files. And tweak advanced options like increasing the number of parallel transcode jobs or enabling video encoders. Once you've finished configuring how you would like your ISG to work, you can return to your Mac menu and tell the ISG to start scanning again. Just make sure you finish configuring your ISG to work the way you want it to before you start the scan. So let's start the scan. Now, if I go back to the top level of my Iconik domain, you can see the ISG is starting to transcode and add proxies of the assets on my local desktop folder into Iconik, ready to manage. If I go into an asset and click Files in the left-hand menu, you can see that the original file for this asset lives on my new ISG. And that's the high-level overview for setting up an ISG on macOS for Iconik. I hope that you found this information useful and that it makes it easier for you to set up ISGs for indexing your local assets on Iconik. If you need more information, head to the Iconik Knowledge Base, where you can find a lot more help and detail about setting up ISGs. And that's everything for today. Thanks for watching.